Oh, hi. How are you?
Welcome to the 2024 Lancaster County Brewers Guild Ale Trail Passport Program. So we got right here the 2024 Ale Trail Passports, and if you have yours in front of you, if you turn with me to page number 4, we're going to start with how it works. So this is for the customer to be able to understand how it works. However, it helps you understand the customer's perspective so that you know what to expect when someone is working it, how it works. Bring your passport when you visit all our member breweries. Objective 1, enjoy a full pour, flight, entree, merchandise, or something to go. Basically a transaction. That will take care of the first objective. The second objective is identical to the first objective. I know it says unless otherwise specified, but as of recently, we're keeping it very, very simple, and we're not going to let breweries define what objective 2 is. This was for the time where that was going to be an option. I would encourage, for the sake of simplicity and to avoid any confusion, just keep it simple with objective 1 and 2 are essentially the same thing. And once they complete both of those, then you will stamp their passport. And we'll do a demonstration of that in a little bit. So objective 3, have a great time. Easiest objective to complete. We hope everybody completes it. If they don't, they still get a stamp. They still get their prizes. And hopefully they'll change their mind about their good time later. So that is the How It Works page, followed by a directory of all 27 member breweries so they can check them off as they go and see how their progress has been made throughout the duration of their Ale Trail Passport Experience 2024. The next pages involve all of you wonderful people, all of your brewery pages with your objectives listed on them, starting in alphabetical order with our good friends at Artifice, Ales and Mead. So for the sake of an example, I promised I will deliver. Once Artifice has checked off both objectives for the customer, they can then, I highly recommend if you don't have a logo stamp, get one of those ASAP. It makes it a lot easier, keeps your brand right there when you stamp complete on the passport. Now, as people start completing their objectives and their breweries, we have different prize thresholds. If you turn to the second to last page of the passport, we've outlined 5 prize point levels for you, starting with 5 breweries completed gets a sticker, 10 gets a magnet, 15 gets a koozie, 20 gets a glassware, and then 27 is the completion. We will have hats available at Cartel for those folks that are finishing all 27 breweries. It's up to you guys. When someone says, hey, I've completed 5 breweries, take a quick gander at their passport. We don't think they're lying, we never do. Whether or not they are, regardless of that, sign off on the brewery initials. You've all been provided with an allotment of stickers, magnets, and koozies. Now, a koozie is really cool. So when you are in a hot summer day or even just hanging out at your house, the cool thing about this, and I actually, I can attest to this personally right now, keeps your beer cold. So how we do this is, and I'm gonna try to be as appropriate as possible, we take your koozie, take your can there, in case a customer asks. And there you go. Keeps it cold for probably an extra 5 to 10 minutes. And those are the 3 items that our customers and Ale Trail participants can receive from all 27 of you guys. As far as the glassware, just like last year, we will be having those at 3 locations around the county. We've always gone with Poor Man's in Ephrata, kind of take care of the folks on that side of town. New Duck in Elizabethtown, and our place here in the center of the city, or in the center of the county rather. at Cartel. So those will be the three places that you'll have to send customers to get their glass. And then for the final completion of the passport, which we've been setting at as the end of the year, so December 31 is kind of the soft date. I know some people have kind of ventured in here in early January, and we've still been able to honor that for the most part if we're here and we're able to log them this year prior to obviously ordering the t-shirts for last year. So for this year, we will be placing a hat order, and we will keep them here and have them available immediately upon receipt of a completed passport. While supplies last, we'll kind of figure out how many we need, and if we are able to get more, we'll see. Hopefully the participation rate just keeps going up, and we do more than 300 completions this year instead of the 270 or so that we did in 2023. So all good things. Let us know if you have any further questions. Hopefully this was detailed and thorough and explained everything about the 2024 AL Trail Passport Program. You guys have fun out there. If you have any questions, let us know. If not, see you on the AL Trail.